Dr. David Kimbrough and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
The Matanzas Reserve, south of St. Augustine, is in a transition zone. To the south, the coast is dominated by mangrove habitat. To the north, salt marsh.
Mangroves don't have a very great cold tolerance, so if it freezes and is a sustained freeze, they typically will die. A couple years ago, we came out to the site with Ed Proffitt, who was visiting from Florida Atlantic University. And Ed has done a lot of work on mangroves, and he asked if there were any in St. Joe Bay, and I said, yeah, I don't really think so. And then we walked out, and lo and behold, we found one right off the bat. It turns out there are more than we realized, because they're shrubby, they're not full-grown trees.
This was the largest of the mangroves in 2010.
When we first came out, this large mangrove had lots of propagules on it, which are basically the seeds of the mangroves. And you can see that they don't fall very far from sort of the mother tree. I'm just surrounded by little mangrove seedlings here, which have become increasingly more abundant in the last few years. If these mangroves continue to expand, particularly with climate change and warmer winters, what's that gonna do in the marsh? Will the mangroves sort of take over the marsh, or will they change the services that the marsh habitat provides in these coastal systems?
With this in mind, Randall conducted an experiment.
In this experiment, we're interested in understanding whether black mangrove propagules that we collected from down south in Florida survive differently than the ones that we collected from here in St. Joe Bay. So the idea is that the mangroves that have survived the winters in St. Joe Bay may be more cold tolerant and may survive and grow better in this area than the ones collected from down south.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.